gang, this is Stormy. Welcome back to Sea of Flame 2. This is a map that Vex made a few years ago. We're playing in version 1.4.7, and we're just going to jump right into fighting with a bunch of slimes and skeletons and zombies and all kinds of stuff, because that seems to be the routine down here. Whew! Why not? Oh, damn it, that's why not. Fire sword. Forgot my sword has fire. Wow, he's like leaving particles everywhere. That's how you know when an Enderman is pissed. They just, you know, it's like particles there. Oh god, we're almost out of food. I didn't come out of here, obviously. Between episodes. To restock. Usually I do, but I didn't. Why? Because I was locked in heated combat. God, I'm so glad he didn't blow up. Do I have my armor? Oh, my helmet broke. I can't hold on to a helmet. I can't seem to get what's behind me very safe. So I've got, because they're up there. And I can't, and also slimes. Because they're everywhere. What? Is there something about the older maps and stuff that, oh, see, now that slime pushed me into the monsters. Did you guys see what happened there? I don't want to use that. We're not really in dire straits yet. Would you guys? That guy with the glowy bow really hurts. I think it's him that's just wrecking me. Now, slimes, go the hell away, please. Because you guys are driving me nuts. Die, damn it. Hey, you dropped your bow. Cool, what did it have? Power 2. Yeah, that was wrecking me. That's actually a decent bow. I'll keep it and combine it with something. Ooh, we're going to be leaving here at some point. Look at all those monsters. Tariq hit. But in the meantime, I have an idea. Can you guys hear me trying to run, but I keep interrupting my run? But run, not rum. Run, I swear to God, I'm sober. Run by having to jump. Get, go. You know what? Let's get up high. Lava. I'd go the other. There you go. Perfect. Now, I can't really get the lava to flow very well in here because of all the holes everywhere, but it's doing all right. Oh, that feels so good. Oh. Now I know why Zisto does it. Well, I mean, I figured out why Zisto does it when I was playing, wow, all the knockback stuff, and I managed to use the one that doesn't have it. Oh, it's Fire Arrow. There's a map, and I forget. Maybe it was, Amleth, Uncharted Territory 3. There's a map that has, knockback on your bow, so that if you melee enemies with it, you knock them back. It's something I only use, like, once or twice, but it was always a situation like that, where I just ended up mousing to the wrong thing. And so I appreciated the ability to do that. I want to know why this area is so covered, protected. Now, it could just simply be a case of it's, you know, we're compressing the darkness. But it doesn't feel that way. It feels more like this is important for some reason. Maybe that's wishful thinking. But seriously, if you guys don't quit pushing me into the creepers, you're going to get me killed. Well, that's part of the problem. There's a damn. I know you're here. I know you exist because I just saw a zombie pop up. Okay, stop, Storm. There. Yep. Whoa, jump, jump. I've been getting better. I haven't been accidentally jumping so much. Thank you. I need that. I can't kill you. Jesus, that was stupid, but it worked. Did I get anything? No. Mostly, I just wanted to see if I could do it. That's all. That's all that was, you guys. Almost killed me. Why are there so many Endermans? Oh, I can't kill you guys. I mean, if I hit him with my fire sword, it'll get rid of him. But it won't. I can't kill him with it. There better be something over here, or I'm going to be... I mean, what a tease, really. I need to back up, because I don't have a healing potion on my bar anymore. Wow, that was... look at that! Oh! Son of a bitch. I can't run. I'm stuck. Alright, really, Vex? Oh, fudgesicles. I'm out of food. Is there any food in here? Great, we have a pork chop. I don't have an axe. Get away. I need to get up there. Damn it, scroll! I don't know if you guys can tell how much trouble I'm having with that scroll, but it's seriously pissing me off. I can't scroll one spot. I know there's one up here. Why do they have to be so damn hard to find when they're up in the ceiling? Like, those are the ones you want to find the most. Because enemies falling on your head is a serious problem. Is it right there where that block is missing? No? Glad I have this amazing pick. Maybe I lit it up enough, it's not gonna spawn anymore? There's obviously clearly one up there, too. I'd kind of like to get this safe so that shit stops coming up behind us, because that's... Yeah, that's really dangerous, obviously. You know, you go to run away. God damn it. And you can't run away, because there's bad guys. We got to get up there. Because creepers are landing on us. We cannot have that. That is simply unacceptable. Where are you guys? Well, that's my torch. I don't want to light it up, but I have to light it up. Where are you guys coming from? Damn it, I know you're here. You've almost killed me a few times because you're landing on me. Where are you? I like how I'm being quiet while I look because, you know, you can totally hear the spawners. Wouldn't that be good? Like if you could hear them? And suddenly it's not spawning anymore. Am I full? Ooh, I'm full. Did I light it up enough? Maybe? I don't know. I know there's a lot more things in here. Fun boxes. We haven't found them all. I'm gonna have to leave in a minute, go get food though. Which is fine. Fortunately, it's not that far away. Now, he could be a natural spawn, because he was just in the dark. What the heck is going on outside my door? If you guys hear that, I'm sorry. I don't know why my door is rattling around like that. Maybe somebody's trying to get in. My doorknob is funky, so you have to play with it, because I live... My house still has antique doorknobs. Like, you can totally look through the keyhole. I tried it. I did. I tried looking through the keyhole, just out of curiosity. You know what? You can't see shit through a keyhole. And it's got the big skeleton key type keyholes, you know, the kind that you would look through. And I suppose, I mean, if you're comparing it to your ability to see things through a modern keyhole, like, say, a quick set keyhole or whatever, then, you know, yeah, but you can see a lot more, but you still can't see anything. And I'm going to start looking for a spawner up in the air again, because I'm so good at finding those. I I really think I'm better off to just try to light it up. There we go. I don't really want coal in my food spot. Let's put zombie flesh down there. We've got plenty of that, and that'll get us out of here. As long as I don't get into too much combat, I say as I press further. There's a chest. Whoa! Whoa! Complete and total frame rate seizure. What the hell? Why is that happening? Yikes! Get in the lava. Let's get up out of here. Oh, it's a burning... I couldn't figure out what was over there. It's a burning slime. Let's get out of here. Let's go get some more food. Maybe I can get up to level 30 and enchant something. Really, if I just go around and pick up all these experience points and kill the slimes, I should easily get to level 30. Look at all these slimes, you guys. It's stupid how many slimes are down here. And they don't despawn, so I have to kill them. And there's a skeleton coming up behind me. But I don't want to deal with him because I'm trying to fight with the slimes. You know what? If these guys push me into lava, I'm going to be annoyed. But I'm level 30, and I don't want to waste time killing them when I'm already a level 30. I went a weird way, didn't I? Bye, creeper. Bye, creeper. That's okay. This is a big area. Like, you don't really realize it. I didn't anyway. Maybe you guys did, but I didn't really realize it until right at first anyway. Or not until right at first. I didn't realize it at first how big this area is, because it goes around that hill that we were just looking at. If it's not the backside of, like, this one, then, you know. I didn't see any obvious way to get to it, but I did see a loot chest on there. So we gotta go get that. We gotta. Unfortunately, I'm out of food at base, too, which means I have to grow more potatoes. The bright side is bone meal is, you know, wonder grow in this version. Bad news is fortune does not affect the drops of potatoes. So I can't use my fortune pick to get stupid numbers of potatoes. Somebody said that they looked in the changelog for that and couldn't find it in the changelog. I don't know about, I mean, I believe they looked. It's not that. I you know, the commenter's been watching my videos forever. I can't pronounce his name, but, you know, he's been watching my videos forever. The thing is, it changed. Whether it's in the changelog or not, and if it's not, I don't know why, but I can tell you it most certainly changed. I did some testing of it when I was playing, I think, Legendary, and I first realized that, hey, fortune wasn't working. I did some testing, and it seems like in 1.6, it seems like when they nerfed bone meal, they made the either that version or the next version, they made fortune affect the drops when they nerfed bone meal. Maybe. Now, I didn't, you know, I don't remember exactly when they nerfed bone meal, but I want to say it was 1.5. Well, I know it wasn't 1.4. I think it was 1.5 they nerfed bone meal. Oh, God. There's a skeleton. And I want to say that... Oh. Okay, this is actually a serious problem. See? We totally just spawned there. Wow, I'm about dead. Okay, let's hurry back to base. I'm going to be really annoyed if I die with 30 levels getting back to base to enchant something. Wow, I should have cut. I would have cut, but it never got quiet. Now I'm gonna pause and I'm gonna grow some stuffs and I'll be right back. Holy shit, that was scary. Stay tuned. By the way, if you guys ever get curious about how I've been getting levels to enchant stuff, this is how. Also, pulling stuff out of the furnace. Also, those fun boxes. That's how I'm getting my levels. I repaired our armor with the, 23 of the levels that I had. And so I'm going to finish cooking this up and then cook up the potatoes and then get what experience points I can. Then I will enchant a helmet. But I just wanted to show you guys. Also, we are fixed for coal. And I just put, you know, that and that for the potatoes. So, all right, I'm going to finish doing all this, and I will be right back with you guys. Okay, we're back, and we have things. I repaired our armor. Oh, I showed you guys already. It wasn't expensive. And also, what else did I do? Food. We got food, more torches. I guess that's it. Oh yeah, helmet. So, we are. Oh God, slimes. Slimes everywhere. The slimes fapping on everything, making a mess. There we go. Anyway, that was lame. Sorry, my bad. Let's get back over here. No, we sure can get around here faster now. I guess. Found one. which is good. I need the XP. But I think we're doing okay. Like, we are finding fun boxes and stuff. So. And as much as I hate. There's a creeper that just fell. Oh my god, from up there. Seriously, skeleton? Go to hell. See, now here I go again, trying to find a fun box. It's in a thing. I find them pretty good on the ground. I know there's one in here. I know there's one in here. Your drain gurgling. Old house, old plumbing. I could call the landlord, but eh. Stupid slime. Okay, terrific. Again, I can't find the thing. I don't want to dig up this whole damn assembly. Mean, I have a good pick, but he needs to mark them. I wish they were marked somehow. That's like my only complaint. Especially the ones up in the air. Like if there was a unique block or something. Or even those ones where it's missing one block. Just something to mark it so that I could find them. I just see sparks, or is that where I dug one up already? I think I already dug one up there. They natural spawns? That's an awful lot of them up there. I don't think that's natural spawns. Not to mention that, oops, it's a lot of different kinds. And obviously, I mean, this is not a waste of time trying to find these spawners. These are a problem because they're dumping monsters on our head. Monsters keep falling on my head. Fetches and his fun boxes said, "It's gonna rain monsters. Good luck finding my secrets. I'm gonna hide 'em well from you, Stormy Dear." Or more accurately, it'd be Laura's butt. Whatever. Sooner or later, find a way to, you know. Okay, if I can't find them, I guess if I can light up the thing. I'm kind of digging in random spots. I don't know how else to find it. At least we're getting like crap tons of cobble. So that's helpful. Yeah, I guess, since I can't find it, I'll just light this up and because I'm pretty sure that they were coming from a fun box up there. Or somewhere. The thing is, there weren't that many, so I have a feeling that it's mostly lit up wherever they're coming from. Now, let's see. Did I miss anything over here? Probably. Where did you come from? I just realized. Donk, donk, donk. You could tell I was just running, putting torches down. With this many fun boxes, you don't want any dark areas or spots because they have quite the range on them, just, you know, collectively. So, you guys are falling from up there. Yep. So I'm just. Yep, they're up there. Okay, let's get up there. Creeper was annoyed he fell. Creepers get pissy when they fall. Have you guys noticed that? Like, they fall and then they just, like, bam. Like, they don't even care. They have zero Fs to give. They fell, and so they're going to blow up, which makes no sense, really. You'd think they'd go limping off holding their ankle? Do creepers have ankles? Point is, blowing up because you fell off a thing seems really, really overreactive if you're a creeper and blowing up ends your life. I almost just walked off there because I didn't realize there was a block missing. Wow, that was close. Did you guys butt clench? But it did. Damn it. I just broke a block there. Why would I want a block there? Is there a reason there's glowstone? God damn it! Is there a reason there's glowstone over here? Now, this is something you don't see now, are these hanging blocks. But I'm not saying it's, you know, a bad thing. I'm just saying, like, he doesn't do that anymore. Well, if nothing else, that's not terrifying. We can see. Also, I lit this up. Oh, there's the exit. Okay, so this does swing around. So maybe it's not as big as I thought it was for a minute. Except over there. There's something over there yet. So let's go over there. You know what? Let's do this while we're up high. Yeah. And out of the void fog. Let's go see what we see over here. How about that? Let's clear out the... Well, that was exciting. But where have we ended up? I have to be really careful, obviously. Oh, there's the chest I was after. I see you over there. Honestly, I heard you first. Can I just say, not worth it? Totally not worth what I went to get here. Now, the Sharpness 4 sword and the Pit of Ghasts, worth it. Totally worth it. Stone tools and food low. On a rock that I would have had to bridge to, except I had Ender Pearls. Although it's not that dangerous over here, aside from getting here. See, there's that scroll problem I'm having. Alright, so let's do this. Let's take our lives in our hands and go up. I think we've covered the entire dungeon. Now, there's still iron down here. There's still darkness and stuff up there, but honestly, I'm tired of digging around in these damn things. We got the wool, so let's leave. I think that's it for down here. I think we've covered it. I think we've explored it. We have a few minutes left, so I'm going to get up out of here. I have an idea. We're going to go exploring a little bit because I'm not sure. Have I found Dungeon 9 yet? I thought I had, but it could have been like a different map that I'm remembering Dungeon 9. I don't know. But we're going to take a walk. There's an area that I know we have not explored. I've not explored it that well. So we are going to... Can I make this any quicker? Like if I put... Because I get tired of coming out of there. And I'm going to do this now that I'm like almost done unless I need iron. Well, I'll... almost certainly be in there for more iron, but ow. Quicker, but not necessarily safer. Go away. Hey. Oh, really? Screw off. Well, this isn't... The problem is that that is like on the back side of the area compared to where you come in. Yeah, see? Yeah, I should have just walked around. Whatever. Whatevs. All right. I will be... Well, I'll be right back and we will go explore something else. Oh god, I hope there's not a skeleton to shoot me off this bridge. So let's sprint jump, because if he hits me mid-sprint jump, I'm going in the lava. There's a skeleton. Stop sprint jumping. Okay. I'll be back. Okay, we're back, and we are here on this obsidian island again. Now, this is where dungeon number 1, 2, and 5, I think, were. But it occurs to me that we haven't really explored it very well, have we? Well, I haven't. I'm sure you guys, I mean, you guys haven't. You know what I mean. Anyway. So, and I thought I saw some brick over here when I was dancing around up there. Also, I managed to accidentally jump. You know, my accidental jumping that I do sometimes screwed me and I jumped into lava. I was able to swim out of the lava, granted only for a couple seconds, and then I used a couple of health pots to keep from dying. So, yep, I was like, well, whoops. All right, hi, spider. You guys are tame because it's daytime. I think I saw a chest over here. I'm putting torches down so that I can see, you know, that I've been here. I don't really want to light all this up that well because of the whole spawning thing. I don't want to take away spawning space, but... Oh, another flak vest! Sweet. Thank you, Vex. I don't have an axe. But I really, really want to take that chest so I don't get confused. There we go. I hope you guys don't hear that dog. That's a neighbor dog. It's not my dog's. Why not? Use an ender pearl to get over here. Yes, brick! Oh, wow. Awesome. Oh, for a minute, that looked like it was cheaty gravel. I was like, what? Okay, so there's... What are you? Mossy cobble. What number are you? The Lost Caves. Can I have a number? I didn't really intend on being here yet. I can tell. Uh-oh. Like, I certainly need to do this at night, but I would like to see a number, please. Well, I'm kind of learning that areas like this, also the one we just did, the Raid Shadow or whatever that's called, these are... In a sense, not innocence, in a sense, there's nothing innocent about a Vex map. In a sense, they are intersections. They contain multiple walls, you know, and things that you do, and places you go. So, yeah. Area, Oblivion Spires. Okay, so that's still, that's the brick I saw from over yonder. Is there anything over here? I didn't see anything over here. Okay, cool. So I guess in the next episode, we are going to be going into the Lost Caves. Doesn't that sound exciting? Like, I love that. I love that name. Sounds all mysterious and stuff. I am going to wait until nighttime to do them because, oh my god, at the number of spawns in there. And I can tell you guys, probably, that's going to be a thing to think about. It would be most logical to bridge from over there, but the thing is, I'd be a long bridge, and I was making a bridge over lava when I managed to randomly jump into the lava because I accidentally hit my jump button. So we are not going to have our thumb anywhere near our jump button. Although my daughter, who's watching me, almost made me throw my sword into lava because she, like, put her hand down on my desk, and when she did, she bumped my ring finger on my left hand, and that finger hovers above the Q. I mean, you know. So when she hit it, I threw my sword. Fortunately, it landed on the bridge and not in the lava. It was like, oh my goodness, that was close. I would have raged. Anyway, not really, really. I mean, you know, I'm not irrational, but... I would have been greatly, greatly saddened by it. All right, gang, I'm going to go. This episode has been in the 25 minutes-ish range. So probably this is a good, well, I know this is a good time to stop because I'm not going to start the new area halfway through the, or at the tail ass end of the video. So yeah, I'm going to go. But I hope you all are enjoying this. I'm having a great time. I love this map. Seriously, and I've told Vex I love this map. This is a terrific map. So I am going to go. But everybody, thank you guys so much for watching and take care. How often do I log off looking at this stupid tree? And it's an ugly tree. What void are, or not what? What biome? Desert? Yeah, I kind of figured. All right, anyway, everybody, take care. Bye now.